this step-by-step installation video, we will show you how to create a single slope, waterproof, and ready-to-tile linear drain shower using our wedi Fundo Riolito Neo Modular. This system consists of a line module, which includes the drain, and an extension module to create the needed sloped shower floor space. Different sizes are available. Prior to installation, check the drain assembly box from your wedi supplier to ensure you have all parts required for the drain installation. Ensure the subfloor is even, flat, load-bearing, and clean. The measurements should be calculated from framing to center of the 2-inch waste pipe in the floor, so the cutout in the subfloor can be made using a template provided by wedi. The 2-inch pipe is cut off at 1¼ inches below the top of the subfloor. The wedi drain trap is installed to the 2-inch waste pipe first. As you can see, the drain trap here is oval, and it will fit tightly into the cutout in the subfloor, so the trap's flanges should rest on the subfloor. Use primer and solvent cement glue appropriate for the pipe and drain material you will connect now. Wedi's drain here is made from ABS, so if your floor pipe is made of PVC or a different plastic, we recommend using a multi-purpose primer and solvent cement if permitted by local plumbing code. Here you can see how the line drain module will connect to the extension module through prefabricated Z-notch connections and wedi joint sealant. We now proceed to install the rubber sealing gasket to the underside of the line drain module or panel. The rubber sealing gasket is inserted into a pre-made channel, and this fit must be tight all around. Use the screws provided in the drain box to hand tighten the gasket once fitted in. Check for a completely tight fit. Now we are mixing modified cement-based thin-set mortar. It is imperative for the system to work safely that the thin-set mortar provides full coverage and support underneath the wedi shower base parts. Here we are using a 1¼ by 1¼ square notch trowel to apply thin-set to the floor. Keep the drain trap clean. Apply only enough thinset to install the line drain module first. Using the same 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch square notch trowel, we apply thinset mortar to the underside of the line drain module. When back-buttering thinset, the trowel lines should always point in the same direction. Be careful not to let thinset mortar touch the rubber sealing gasket or foam of the Z-notch connections. If this happens, the mortar has to be thoroughly cleaned from these areas using moist paper towels or sponges. The line drain module is now connected to the wedi drain trap. The rubber sealing gasket has to fit tightly and all the way into the trap. It is a good idea not to fasten the trap's flanges to the subfloor, so it may still offer a bit of flexibility and move along with the rubber sealing gasket pushing into the trap. Apply firm pressure on all areas of the panel to ensure good bond. Add some weight equally, but do not step or stomp on the panel so critical internal seals of the line drain will not be damaged. Now take measurements to determine the size of the sloped extension module required, which is then cut to fit. Here we are installing a 3x5-foot shower. Make sure to purchase the base modules long and wide enough for your shower, then cut down to size if needed. While the extension modules can be cut shorter, the line drain modules cannot be cut. The line drain modules can also be used as an integrated drain within sloped mortar bed assemblies. This application should be topically waterproofed with the waterproofing connecting to the line drain module. Subliner dry sheet waterproofing membrane is recommended for those applications. Our installer now measures and marks the cut line on the extension module. A circular saw is used to cut cleanly through the panel. be sure to wear safety glasses. The saw should have a carbide blade so it won't wear out quickly by cutting through the cement coating surfaces. If the saw blade is not long enough to cut through the entire panel, use a handsaw to cut through the remaining parts. A dry fit of parts helps to ensure we have made the correct cuts. Now cut Z-notch channels at the side of the extension module that has been cut. By adjusting the blade to the depth and width of the needed channel, and by using a guide for the saw, this is done quickly and cleanly. Make sure to always clean off all cutting dust. Dust could act as a bond breaker to wedi joint sealant or thin-set mortar. We're now doing one more dry fit test, making sure we are ready to complete the shower floor by installing the extension module. More modified thin-set mortar is mixed and applied to the underside of the extension module. To achieve full coverage and adhesion when applying thin-set mortar, it will be helpful to spread the thin-set mortar with the flat side of the trowel first, before combing through the mortar forming channels. To stay consistent, we are using a 1/4 inch by 1/4 inch square notch trowel again, and channels will be combed pointing in one direction. Make sure to remove excess thinset and to keep your panel's edges and channels clean. Thinset mortar is now spread on the floor using the same trowel. Channels are combed pointing in one direction, and it should be the same direction in which the channels on the underside of the extension point. Our installer has marked the area that needs to be covered with thinset to make sure there will be full coverage of thinset application for the extension module. A 1/2 inch bead of wedi joint sealant is now continuously applied to the Z-notch channel of the line drain module. This is followed by another 1/2 inch of wedi joint sealant continuously applied to the vertical area of the extension module Z-notch. The parts are now connected and kept under tight pressure. Excess joint sealant is removed. Apply a topical application of wedi joint sealant over the connection seam, spreading it flat with a putty knife. This step can also be performed later, just prior to the completion of the installation. We are now ready to install the waterproof wedi building panels on the shower wall framing. As you can see, the panels are extremely lightweight, but they will act as a strong backer board once installed. They are cut using a score and snap method, or you can also just cut through the entire panel using a utility knife. When installing the wall panels, continuous 1/2 inch beads of wedi joint sealant are applied between panels and between shower base channels and panels. All wall panels are pushed into the sealant tightly and fastened using wedi washers and screws at 12-inch intervals, starting 1 foot up from the base. Additional fasteners are set into seams between wall panels to create flush transitions. The washers will be sunk right below the wedi building panel surface to make for a great flat surface to tile on. A final step to seal and reinforce the assembly is to apply another 1/2 inch bead of wedi joint sealant over all seams. Use a wedi putty knife to spread the sealant flat. Our installer now installs a freestanding wall without framing using a 2-inch wedi building panel instead. These panels are available in sizes up to 4 feet wide. Walls like the one used here can be installed without any further support for up to a length of 4 feet. The panel is cut to size using a skill saw, hand saw, or utility knife. A Z-notch channel is made into the bottom side of the panel, where it will connect to the wedi Fundo shower base's Z-notch channel. The wall unit is now dry fitted, and our installer checks for a plumb and square installation. The attachment areas on wall and floor are marked so that wedi joint sealant can be applied in the right areas. Half-inch beads of wedi joint sealant are applied to the Fundo shower base Z-notch channel and the wall unit's Z-notch channel, as well as on wedi building panels, over framed structures, and over the subfloor attachment areas. When using wedi joint sealant as not only a waterproofer but also as a strong adhesive, it is important to apply it with all parts pushed together tightly so compression can be applied to the wedi joint sealant for at least 20 to 30 minutes. As demonstrated here, we are using wood scraps to install a temporary construction to apply pressure against all attachment areas. To complete the basic shower assembly, we now install a wedi curb. The curbs are sloped on the top so that water flowing down from doors will easily be let back into the shower. The curb is cut to fit tight between wedi walls. Thin-set mortars apply to the underside of the curb using a 1/4 by 1/4 inch square notch trowel. The same procedure is repeated on the floor so the curb can rest in full thin-set support. Wedi joint sealant is applied in continuous half-inch beads in the shower base Z-notch channel, over the full attachment surface where curb ends meet the walls, and at the vertical Z-notch area of the curb where it meets the shower base Z-notch channel. The curb is now positioned to connect with the shower base. Apply pressure and weight on the curb so that the joint sealant and thin-set mortar are kept under compression for approximately 30 minutes. More wedi joint sealant in half-inch beads is applied over the seams of the assembly, which have not yet been topically sealed and reinforced. The topical treatment of seams in the assembly can be done in one step at the end of the assembly. It is important to do this step thoroughly and distribute the sealant over all seams using a putty knife. You want to make sure the application is not producing buildup in corners or other areas, but will still form a solid coverage 3/4 of an inch on both sides of every seam and a minimum of 1/16 of an inch thick. The last step is to install one of the three available drain cover options: the standard polished stainless steel option, the exclusive brushed stainless steel option with a heavier plate, or the tileable cover. Here our installer chose the exclusive option. Just like the standard cover in polished stainless steel, it can be installed flush with floor tiles ranging in thickness from 3/16 of an inch up to 7/8 of an inch, including a thin-set bed under the tile. The cover supports can be extended or cut to a lower setting. For that, you will need the Allen key included with every cover. Drain cover and supports are now placed into the channel, and supports fit into little depressions pre-made in the channel. Do not glue the covers or supports into the channel. It is important that the cover can be removed later so the drain can be cleaned. You can now tile a completely waterproof, mold-proof, and even insulating shower. We have installed a shower completely made from wedi system components, so this entire installation is protected by wedi's warranty programs, available for 10, 15, or 20-year durations. More information can be found at wedicorp.com.